So here is another question, guys. So the question says, what does area under a velocity time graph give? Okay, so whether does it give distance, acceleration, displacement, or none of the above? So let's first find out what does it mean, right? So area under a velocity time graph. Again, just to remind, this is velocity time graph. So in motion chapter, you would have come across at least two varieties of such graphs. One is position time graph, displacement time graph, or position time graph or displacement time graph, or velocity time graph. These are the things, right? So what does velocity time graph give? Okay, so let us first draw the graph. This is x and y coordinate axis. So this x is nothing but our t. So this is t and this is velocity. Isn't it? This is what a velocity time graph looks like. And let us say the graph is something like this. Okay. What are these values? So here it is t is equal to t1. And at t equals to t1, the body was moving with velocity v1. And let me say this is t is equal to t2. Okay. This is t is equal to t2. And corresponding to this t2, the body had velocity v2. I'm writing it here. So what does the area under the curve? First of all, understand what is area under the curve. So if I have to, just let me take another color for better understanding. So if I take, yeah, so area under the curve is nothing but area bound between the given graph, the time axis, and the two perpendicular line corresponding to two time values. So between these two time, okay, this is what is area. So we have to basically calculate this area. We don't need to calculate, we need to understand what exactly this means. So for that, what we are going to do is, let me take another color for how do we find out what exactly does it give. Okay, so let me take this one. Now if you take any time t, right, any time t, and corresponding to that time t, let us say this is my v, okay, and let's say take some time after t, but at a very small time gap. Okay, so I'm saying this time gap is, or this time is actually t plus delta t, small delta t is there. So, and then again draw a vertical line to find out its corresponding velocity value. Let's say this value is v plus delta v. Now understand once again, at time t the velocity was v, okay, no doubt. At time t the velocity of the object is v, which is given by this point. So this is at this location, at this time this is the velocity. And at t plus delta t, so this gap, if you see this gap, this gap is nothing but delta t gap. So in the duration delta t, so I'm writing delta t here. So in delta t time gap, the velocity increases by some value delta v, right? So hence this location, now this point is v plus delta v. Okay, now don't you think this particular diagram here, so let me name it. So let's say this point here is A, this B, this is C, and this point is D. So ABCD looks like a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium. Isn't it? Now what is the rough cut area of, roughly, what is the rough area of this trapezium? So if delta t is too small, so this trapezium is almost like a rectangle, right? So this is anyways 90 degree, this is anyways 90 degree, so only this slant line is there. But if delta t is too small, you can say that this is almost like a rectangle. So hence nearly this ABCD has an area, what, AD into, assuming it to be closer to the rectangle. So AD into AB, almost like a rectangle. Yes, it's not exact, but somewhat. Now what is AD? If you see AD, AD is nothing but the V. Check, this AD here is same as this V in this axis. And what about this AB? AB is nothing but delta T if you check. Isn't it? So now, it is as good as saying that for delta t amount of time, the velocity was v. And hence, this particular quantity is nothing but distance traveled or displacement traveled, in this case velocity is given, so displacement traveled in delta t time, right, at a velocity, at a velocity, how much? V, isn't it? So hence this small area, if I shade it using this green, so this area is displacement covered in delta t time. So don't you think if I add all these small trapeziums, though, you know, if you somehow find out the exact trapezium area, then don't you think this will give you the displacement cover between t1 and t2? So if in ABCD, you can see in delta t time, the displacement cover is given. So from t equals to t1 to t equals to t2, if you add all such small trapezium areas, you'll get what? Displacement covered. So hence area under VT graph gives what? Gives displacement. Again, remember, it gives you displacement. Area under VT graph gives displacement. If it is speed time graph, it will give you distance. Simple. So yeah, so hence distance will be from speed time graph. Speed time, right? So hence right answer is C in this case. But how do I get acceleration from VT? So how do I get acceleration from VT graphs? So if you see, if you have a VT graph, so acceleration is nothing but the slope of the line. Okay, so slope of this curve. Okay, so let's say this is delta T and this is delta V. What is delta V? Change of velocity from V1 to V2. Okay, and delta T is change of time from T1 to T2. So my dear friend, this is delta T, isn't it? Okay, so hence acceleration A is given by delta V by delta T, which is V2 minus V1, change in velocity divided by time taken to effect that change, right? In how much time that change was happening. So hence this is acceleration. So acceleration is nothing but, how do I find out acceleration? So what is it actually? So what did we calculate? If you remember the concept of slope, so we calculated slope. So slope of VT graph gives acceleration, isn't it? Right? So this is what is our learning. So distance is given by area under speed time graph, acceleration is given by slope of velocity time graph, and displacement is given by area under velocity time graph. I hope you understood this part.